Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Exchange Church and Grace for today. It is fantastic to be with you. I hope your week's going well and it's all good so far. And I hope you're being encouraged by this. Remember, if you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel, head over there now, ding the bell, subscribe. And if you're on Facebook today, we want to see your friends, family, colleagues, world transformed by grace. So just share this with people, like it, and let's get the word out there that Jesus is good, okay? And he loves people and he will change them. You know, today I'm going to talk about how he is the rock that won't be shaken. And it says in Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. I remember when I was a kid, right? And you know, one of the things that we used to do is we used to hang out. You know, when we were small here, now this is not when I was a teenager, but you would hang out with, you know, all the kids in the street and in the back in the day as you did then. And I can remember the girls picking up daisies, right? And pulling the petals off them and saying like, he loves me not. And then trying to figure out if you actually loved them or not. Now, we were young, okay? I wasn't like 18 at this stage, you know? And, you know, I think, I'm sure you've done that as well. And we know that kind of the outcome of that game, you know, is probably not anything that we would have based our future plans on. Can you imagine that one? Why did you marry such and such? Well, the daisy came up with he loves me on it, so we just went for it, you know. But, you know, there's no way that we would do that. But sometimes, you know, we actually approach the Lord with the same kind of doubts and insecurities, don't we? We kind of go, does he love me? Does he not? Does he love me? Does he not? And we kind of base our relationship with him on how we're feeling in any particular moment. You know, often we think that just because we're going to change our behavior, our emotions might go up and down, or we have negative thoughts in any particular part of the day. You know, if we just stop for a moment, many of us are still thinking and still believing that, you know, that influences how God sees us, but it doesn't. You know, on our best days, we're confident that his love is shining down on us and we can be sure of his favor and blessing, right? That's for sure. Then on our worst days, what do? We kind of hang our heads in shame and we want to hide in the shadows. You know, we want to wait until we can redeem ourselves, don't we, through good behavior. Like, I might have messed up, but I'm going to make it up to you, Lord, or make it up to whoever. You know, we'll do some act of kindness or somehow try to compensate for the fact that I messed up. Now, that's so exhausting to live that way. It's tiring going round and round and round in circles, never knowing exactly where you're standing, right? Always thinking, remember these moments of always thinking that at any time you could mess it all up again, and then you're going to have to go right back to the very beginning and get back into God's good graces. But that's why I love this verse today. That's why Jesus is a rock that you can stand on today. And that's why the truth of that this verse is so powerful. The love that you receive from Jesus at the moment that you accepted him is the same love that you're walking in today and you will walk in for the rest of your life. You see, when we're unstable, he's stable. When you're inconsistent, he is consistent. When we are unfaithful, he is faithful. The Lord's love and grace towards you is never based on how good you think you are, but it's only ever based on how good he is. That's why we can have confidence today, right? That's why you and I can get up and get at it today. Because no matter what's going on in our worlds, our feet are firmly planted in an eternal kingdom, which we are well and truly anchored in. We are going down deep into the soil of God's love. And because we are planted there, then we know every day we can have confidence and assurance of goodness. You know what? Even more, you know, the world is full of uncertainty. It's full of constant change. And so, like, many people around us feel unstable, and lots of people are fearing for the future. You know, the lack of clarity around what's going on in the world, you know, with the economy, pandemic, getting back to work, you know, even like war and bombings and all sorts of stuff. Actually, it leaves people feeling quite vulnerable and afraid, and many people afraid to actually look forward with any kind of sense of confidence because they just don't know what it's going to bring. But can I tell you, you don't need to live like that and you don't need to live in that space. Be encouraged today. You don't need to be swayed by the media, by the prospect of governments or economic crisis, right? Or how much tax you're going to be paying. That was like last week, wasn't it? In the next number of years, because we have a constant. His name is Jesus. In the midst of chaos, Jesus is a rock that you can stand on. You know, there's nothing new to the Lord today. He exists outside of time, and he is the Lord over every hour and minute that we live. Our very breath, and the very breath that you're breathing right now is a gift from him. And what should give us great comfort to know in a world which is a wee bit crazy, very ambiguous, and not a lot, you know, of confidence out there, he remains the same. What you knew about him yesterday is true today, and it'll be true tomorrow. He's reliable. Jesus is steadfast. He's the rock on which you can build solid foundations today. And if you do that, you'll not be shaken. Amen. Thank goodness that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And so, Father, we say thank you for your body broken. Thank you today that we take this, remembering, Jesus, all of your finished work. We thank you for healing, Lord. Every condition, every sickness, every disease, totally healed right now in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you for the cup. Father, thank you that we are the righteousness of God in Christ today. Completely healed, restored, made brand new. Amen. So have a wonderful Wednesday. Hump day. Get over this day. We're sliding into the weekend. So I hope you've been encouraged today. Like and share this, folks. Have a wonderful day, and we'll see you tomorrow for more Grace for Today.